everybody, welcome to my channel, y'all. I did it, finally. All right. So this video is, I need to turn this down before I start singing, hold up. So this video is strictly based on the fact that I'm getting a breast augmentation, y'all. I am so excited, y'all. Y'all don't understand. So this is the disclaimer, okay? I'm not doing this for nobody, okay? I'm doing it for me. I'm doing it because I have the money for it. And if you don't like the way you look, change it. That's what plastic surgeons are for, okay? And one thing I can say as well is my insecurities with my breasts came from after having a child. Every woman knows after having a baby, y'all know how y'all boobies look. Like, I feel like when I take my bra off, my boobs like roll out like fruit roll-ups. Like, or like when, Jesus, I can block that out, right? So, remember when Marlon Wayans on the scary movie, he was like, orangutan titty. Yes, that's me, okay? Ain't no shame in my game, period. All right. Okay, let me tell y'all how I feel about plastic surgery. Oh, did I just say that? I don't remember. But hey, just like I said, what did God put surgeons on this earth for if they didn't want to help people? You know what I'm trying to say? Like, clearly, if you do not like the way you look, I don't care what nobody says. Natural body this, natural body that. But for my daughter, I had natural boobs. I did not need surgery, but this is why I'm getting it. And if I keep looking to the side here, it's because my questions are on it. I've been following Mia Aesthetics for years now, and when I tell you, like, they do a good job. They do a really good job. And you know, from BBLs to breast augmentation, breast lifts, I'm talking about lipo, arm lipo, tummy tucks, I just love their work. So I've always been following them, and I knew that if I ever really went through with it, it would be them. So it's Mia Aesthetics. They have multiple locations, but I'm going to the one in Miami. They have Atlanta, Texas, blah, blah, blah. But come on now, Miami is Miami, so that's why I wanted to go. So, doctors, I will be honest. Did I just spit? Did y'all see that? Okay. I'm gonna be honest though. Doctors, it's always a risk. You can either go with the doctors that's been there for a while and pay like breast augmentation with the lift, which is what I'm getting. I saw a doctor for $7,000. I also saw a doctor for $8,000. But there were, when they are new doctors starting at their location, their prices are lower. So I automatically just went with the starter doctor because it was cheaper. Now, I thought that I could just get a breast augmentation, okay, y'all? Like, I really thought that that's all I needed. But when I tell you that I sent them my pictures and they said, honey, I really don't even think that they did this to take my money. I really feel like this is true because when I told y'all the fruit roll-ups, okay? So they'll say, honey, I'm sorry. Like, to get the your desired look, you're going to have to get a lift along with your breast augmentation. And I respect it because I'll be real mad if I got breast augmentation and my boobs down here and my implants are sitting down here. I'll be very upset. So I ended up going with the breast augmentation and the lift. Now, my doctor, Dr. Haas, I don't know if I'm like jumping back and forth. I'm like, hope y'all understand. I'll be in my own world. So the new doctor or whatever, Dr. Haas, he was $3,500. And I was like, oh, baby, that's in my price range. The breast augmentation with the lift plus the surgical bra came out to $5,150, okay? So the surgical bra is an extra $55. You could take that off, but me personally, I want to make sure that I have what I need in the right thing. You know, I could have bought it somewhere else, but I want to make sure it's the right one, okay? And then they give you a discount if you pay in cash. That means that you cannot just throw it on a credit card. It's money. You can either pay from your debit card, real money, or cash, money orders, whatever. So they give you a discount of $500. So my everything went down to $4,705, okay? So that's how much it costs for a brand new doctor to get a breast augmentation with the lift, with the surgical bra. Now, I took a risk. I did, y'all. My doctor, he's from Kentucky, and the way it works is that they will not post any of his work. Like, once they leave a surgical clinic, they delete all his work. His work is null and void, nowhere to be found. So it's kind of like, once he does his first surgery, that's what you're going to get. So I was very lucky that he came in guns blazing, y'all. His BBLs is lit. His breast augmentation is lit. I actually posted it on my Facebook of what he did. He specializes in breast augmentation, so I lucked up. I really did with the pricing. So you have to pay a 10% discount. So to book your appointment and your date, I had to pay $470.50. So that was my deposit. From there, guys, I would recommend, unless you just have the money now, I would recommend that you schedule far out so that you can save properly, okay? I feel like I just keep spitting. Oh my gosh.
Sis, because you okay. Is.
Sorry. Sorry, son. What the heck? Get out of here. Oh, here it is. I forgot what I was saying. You gotta do that, like, in mid-sentence, you just said a whole bunch and then forget literally what you was just talking about.
Maybe you should stop smoking.
Anyways, okay, so I said how much it was, and so how do you prepare financially? I'm gonna let you know what I did personally. I get paid bi-weekly, so I make sure that something is coming out of my check. And I'm not gonna lie to y'all, what's gonna help is that start yourself off when we do get our tax returns. I'm not gonna lie, do I have $5,000 out my ass? No, I pay rent. I pay rent, I got a child, boom. So it's kind of like every check, you should, you know, put something to the side or with your, with your tax return, you should take a certain amount of money and put it to the side. Now, I was told that you should not pay fully, like pay them fully just in case something happens, that the refunding is like a mess. And what I don't want is that I'm paying $5,000 and it takes them 3,000 years to give it back to me if something goes wrong. So I pay my deposit here, and this is like it's weird, like I pay my deposit and I put at the top like how much I actually paid. So that was my deposit, and then I just did another $500 that I actually paid them, but this was after I figured out not to pay fully, okay? So from there, I'm not gonna show my checks or anything, but I've been a good saving technique is getting money orders in the increments of 500 and 1,000. So I've been like randomly $1,000 here, $500 there, $1,000 here, and my money orders are just sitting, just sitting to the side. Because if I see that money in my account, that shit's gone. That's just me, okay? I'll forget it's for my breast augmentation surgery, and I'm gonna spend that on. So that's a good saving technique that actually works for me. My daughter, she just, this door being closed, it's like she's going crazy out here. Hey! Runs away. Anyways, okay. So, preparing financially, saving techniques, and so sizing, okay, y'all? I am 5'2", 130, and I want to go for a full C, small B. And I just want to be able to, you know, I wear push-up bra. I wear a lot of padding. Like, this might look good, guys, but in here, it's nothing. Look at this crease. Like, look. What is this? Like, I could put my whole hand in there. Put a whole Polly Pocket doll, like, just sitting there, John. Like, you know what I mean, okay? So, that's the size I want to go. Hopefully, you know, when I go for my pre-op appointment, he'll allow me to try on certain things so I can know what I look like. My biggest goal is that I want to be able to sit up fully looking large like this with no bra. So this is like a wish pick right here. Like, I want it just like this with no bra. Not
that stain on your shirt.
I tell y'all, once I get this surgery, ain't no bra be. My next video coming up will be everything I bought to prepare for my surgery, because y'all know I'm extra. You see my I got, like, mind you, this suitcase and everything, this shit was bought like 2 months ago. My surgery is in June. Oh yeah, my surgery date is June 23rd, y'all. So the next video coming up, I will show y'all everything that I bought to prepare for it. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. I actually enjoyed making it. It's so weird, like, looking at yourself, talking to yourself, but I actually like it because I talk to myself anyways. All right, thank you. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know if y'all have any questions that I didn't address in this video that I can address in the next one. And I'm just so happy that I'm able to sit in front of y'all and just tell y'all what's real, because I ain't no fake wrong. Like, I'm getting my boobs done. I'm one of them.